Welcome back from spring break, Hellgate.
And welcome back to another edition of
Hellgate Happenings.
Attention seniors, applications for the Billy Murillo Scholarship are now open. To be eligible, you have to attend the University of Montana for 4 years. You need a GPA of 2.5 or better, and you need demonstrated financial need. You must provide a handwritten or a typed letter. They prefer handwritten. And this should share your attributes as well as your plans for college and future dreams. To apply, bring your envelope addressed to Miss Marilla, to Miss Huguet in room 257 by March 31st. And there will be 3 applicants selected for a 15-minute interview, and 1 winner will be selected after that.
Arabic Honor Society is holding a supply drive for Soft Landing Missoula. Bring any hygiene products, such as laundry detergent, deodorant soap, etc., and place them in these bins around the school.
Pictures and Picture Day are still available, and you can come pick it up in the main office.
Yearbooks are still available for $75. Please bring a check-in to school or order yours today at yearbookforever.com.
Happy birthday this week to Emery Gerard, Felix Hahn, Lucy Hansen, Drew McCutcheon,
Enoch Zunker, David Hishaw, Nora Purgine, Catherine Potts,
Hazeland Seagrave, Chloe Burdine, Miles Biddulf, Vance Biddulf,
Maggie Van, Abdul Azam, Leland Adkins, Samuel Conway, and Logan McFarlane.
Remember, Hellgate,
be safe,
be respectful,
be responsible,
be a graduate,
be a knight.
Have a great day.
Hey guys, Sam here, and today I have some more exciting bills for you that are coming up in the Montana legislature. So first we start with House Bill 329 by its sponsor is Sue Vinton, and this one is to revise the laws relating to the Special Needs Equality Opportunity Act. And so it's mainly meant to help the families and parents of students who do have special needs to pay for their education. And so if approved, the Montana government will help pay, will pay for a student with special needs as education. And it's just meant to mainly give special needs students a better education and an opportunity to learn. The next one, we have House Bill 642. And this one is meant to provide a pilot farm to school grant program for MCPS and for the state that would allow a school or a school community to have a farm, first to allow students to learn about agriculture and growing plants and food, but also to allow the schools to help create food, especially for students who cannot pay for a school-funded lunch. The next one we have is Senate Bill 188 by Mike Lang. And this one is more meant for teachers and retirees. For teachers or specialists, administrators, if you have retired, usually you would not be paid your full amount if you came back to work. But with this law, you could for 3 to 5 years be paid a full salary of what an actual teacher or administrator would make. But you do need to have 30 years of teaching or administrative experience. So this is a lot, but it is meant to help students and retirees who maybe cannot rely on their pension to make more money. The next one we have is House Bill 244. And this is actually to reinstitute the death penalty in Montana. And I'm pretty sure it was we got rid of the death penalty in 2015, but this is meant to bring it back. The next one is House and Senate Joint Bill 4. And so this one is with the with our court system. And so in Montana, we do not have a insanity defense plea like most states, which means that if you do plea the insanity defense, you did not really have full knowledge of what you were doing. But instead of that, we have different terms for that. We have guilty but mentally ill, not guilty due to mental illness, and unfit to proceed to trial. And these are usually established by the court and the judge, and they're really meant to see how, if you should be convicted guilty or not. But this law is meant to bring in a third party reviewer due to the increased amount of the people who are found guilty. And they are meant to make sure that the court's ruling was just, and also to report to the judicial government. The next one is House and Senate Joint Bill 9, and this one is to it's an urge for the mostly for the president and the government to end the war in Afghanistan and take out all of our troops. And and last one, House Bill 273, and this one is Montana. We're one of the states who does not have a we have nuclear energy, but this, and the only way usually to have nuclear energy is to put it on the ballot for people to vote. But with this would repeal the need for people to vote, and it'd allow the government to allow the creation of nuclear energy. And thank you.